I see Veronica. She's alone and looks confused. She actually looks scared out of her mind. What if I had gone the other way? Hey, wait. She stole my flashlight. Tina says, come on, let's go to the pier. Maybe we can see what's going on from there. Okay, I'm not staying home alone. Great! Get dressed and grab your walkie-talkies. We might need them in case we lose track of each other. Oliver says, but we're not going to, are we? Of course not. It's just a precaution. Okay, I'll get the walkie-talkies. The garden is full of crows. I've never seen so many. Oh, did she take the binoculars? I gotta get dressed, too? I've got the walkie-talkies. You're supposed to get dressed, she said. But as this... I don't have anything. I'm going to put on something warm. Oh, he just does it. Okay. Well, I can't look out the... I can't look out the window anymore. Look at that. Oh, she's waiting down there. Now, if you want to stay alive... I don't need to go into Daddy's office again. I have the walkie-talkies. Great, let's go to the pier. And just like that, she walked out of my life. Never to be seen again. Oh, there she is. That's loud. Sparkle is a cat or a dog or a pet crow. I don't think not a pet crow. What's that in the water? Tina says, impossible to see anything from here. They've taken the boat to the other shore. We'll have to walk around the lake on foot. I have a very bad feeling about this. Do you think I'm enjoying this? Of course you are, says Oliver. I don't like it when you get bossy like this, Oliver says. Why does everything have to be done your way? Well, I don't like dragging along a whining, crying baby either. So we both have to put up with that. I guess Tina's older. She's taller. Well, she might just be taller. Oh. Okay, I'm sorry. Sometimes you're not such a crybaby. Just kind of a crybaby. What now? Says Oliver. Tina says, there's something floating in the water. Yeah, I noticed that. Looks like a bag. It's Veronica's bag. Oliver says, are you sure? Yes, see? It has Piero the cat's face on it. It's hers. Did she drop it? We'll never reach it from here. Find me something long to get it with. Okay, maybe a pruner? Did you find something? Maybe. It says the pruner's still there. I'm still picking up the pruner. Alright, do you want this? Pruner? Does it know I have the pruner? It thinks it's still there. Oh, the rope, maybe. Give her the rope? I don't know if it... Are we combining anything? I mean, I have a rope, but it's not... Can I... Go find something long? Like, oh, this! Prune the branch. The evil branch. This will do. Oh, I have it. Okay. I lost the pruner. Okay. Put a rope on it. So I can drag it back. No. Oh. All right. Here. Oh, she fell in. Now we'll get to drown her. Tina! Are you okay? It's very cold. Something's wrapped around my leg. I can't get out. Tina, what do I do? Hey, hey, calm down. Everything will be fine. Says the person in the water with something wrapped around her leg. She's making him feel like everything's fine. Come on, throw me something to hold on to. Here. I better tie the rope somewhere. Did you find help? Alright, tie it here. Bollard? What's a bollard? Alright, I'm tying it to the bollard. I guess it's some implement of a... of a pier. Now go find help. What do you mean, go find help? I threw you a rope. Climb up the rope. Mrs. Jordan is awake, Tina says. I saw a light in her window. Come on, go. I'll be fine. Don't worry. Just hurry up, okay? So why did I throw you this rope? You just hang on to it and sit there? Here, take one of my walkie-talkies, Oliver says. That way I know you're okay. Oh, you know this is gonna... You just threw it in the water. Is this still gonna work? Thank you, says Tina. It's gonna add an element of suspense. We know that. The battery is very low. Of course it is. Find help. Mrs. Jordan's house. Quick. Do I just go through the hole or something? I guess not. Well, this thing's still freaking out. We hear that weird noise? Underneath the ticking, there's a strange sound. And not the boom. I don't know if you can hear it. I guess I go out through the front door, but let me just look around a little bit. It's Tina who needs to worry about staying alive. I wish I could go to bed, but I don't want to stay home alone. Tina's hanging on a rope in the lake, and he doesn't want to stay home alone. That's why he's not going to go to bed. It's locked. Really? Oh, keys. Oh, we got the keys. Okay. Very strange looking house, isn't it? Can't look at anything over here. I better call Tina. I hope she's okay. Tina, are you still there? Yes. I'm freezing, though. Have you found help? I'm on it. Oh, lovely. I hope that's not Sparkle. So what's this way? Probably nothing. This is how my Let's Play videos... get longer than they should be, because I'm off exploring places where you don't really need to go. But sometimes you find interesting things that way. So this is the doorbell. See, I'd like to see what's over here, but there's nothing. Well, they got some lights on. Ding dong! A zombie answers the door. Oliver, says Mrs. Jordan. What are you doing here? Is everything all right? Mrs. Jordan, I need help. Our babysitter was staying with us, but she left us, and we went looking for her, and... Okay, okay, breathe. Come on in. It's cold outside. We kind of need to hurry. Okay, slow down. What happened? Tina fell off the lake, into the lake, off the pier. Oh my God, is she okay? Yes, but she can't get out of the water. She needs help. And where are your parents? They're out. They left us with the babysitter, but she abandoned us. Abandoned us? I wasn't going to say that, babysitter anyway. Okay, I'll run to the pier to help. Oops. I don't think you're going to do any such thing. You're a sister. You stay here and attend Thomas, in case he needs anything. Oh, Thomas is the sick kid? You know he requires special attention. He's in his room. Keep an eye on him, will you? I'll be right back. He's not coming back, ever. It said Mrs. Jordan is still there. She's just outside the door. She's standing there. She's grabbing a smoke first. Two Street. I hope Mrs. Jordan comes back with Tina soon. Well. She's right there, kid. I see her name. Bottle? Oh, is that his medicine? Thomas's medicine, maybe. Oh, no. Oh, what juice? Did you say prune juice? Peach juice. Yummy. Somehow I don't think that's peach juice, kid. I like the bubblegum color. So original. Thomas's room. Let's go upstairs first, though. Thomas's room is downstairs. Fine, kid. I want to look around a little bit. Hello? Thomas? He's a desiccated husk. Oliver, what are you doing here? Tina's in trouble. Your mom went to help her. Really? I thought mom was taking a bath upstairs. Sorry, sometimes my medication makes me confused. Is Tina okay? She fell in the lake and can't get out. Seriously? Well, don't worry. Mom is very strong. She'll pull her out of the water. She works out. Come on, Thomas says. She'll be fine. I swear, though, I thought Mom was chilling in the bathroom. I think there's something else in the bathroom, then. I hate this medication. How do you feel? Says Oliver. Physically or mentally? Mentally. Well, it's only been 2 months since Dad died. That's horrible. It's been hard, and Mom makes me go to therapy with a super boring lady. And physically? I can't take 2 steps without gasping for air. Other than that, I feel wonderful. Okay, then. Can I ask you something that I've never asked you before? You don't have to answer if you don't want to. Thomas says, of course, ask away. You never told me how your father died. That's not a question. I don't know. Mom never talks about it. One day he got a call from the doctor, and suddenly he stopped talking to us. Huh. He spent the rest of his days crying and sleeping. Sorry, says Oliver. I'm sure he loved you very much. I don't know. He changed a lot. About your illness... Are you going to die soon? I'd be very lonely. You're my best friend at school. Thomas says, yeah, no idea. Mom always makes plans for the future. But I think she does it just to cheer me up. That's sad. And what is going on here? We got demons, ghosts here in this painting? This looks spooky too over here. Her words are happy, but her face is sad. But I don't care too much about it. I'm not afraid of dying. Really? I'll go back to the same dark, tranquil place where I was before I was born. I like that idea. We're speechless. Anyway, let's stop talking about sad things. Look, I want to show you something. It's super cool. A Ouija board, says Oliver. I found it in Mom's closet. I think she uses it to talk to Dad.
Really?
Come on, who do you want to contact?
I'm messing with no Ouija board. I don't want to contact anyone.
These things, I don't like them, Oliver says. Come on, Thomas says. There must be someone you miss. Your grandparents? They're still alive. Really? How boring. Come on, give me a name. Okay, I want to contact... Miss Marquez. No, Elvis. Elvis? But he's still alive, on that secret island where all the famous people live, who we think are dead.
Really?
My dog Alias can be Miss Marquez. Nice choice, but we need someone who can respond to the Ouija board.
Yeah, I had a feeling it would be this, so that's why I chose the other two first.
Ms. Marquez, my old nanny. She lived in this house before you moved in, says Oliver. She was great. She had one eye missing and wore an eye patch, like a pirate. One day she suddenly disappeared. Mom told us she went to live on her family's farm in Colorado. But Tina says she saw an ambulance and the police. We think something horrible happened to her. Thomas says, mothers lie, you know? They do it to protect us, but they lie. We are going to contact your old babysitter. If she died in this house, her presence will be super strong.
Well, she got taken by an ambulance. She probably died in the hospital. But anyway, it'll be super cool, you see.
I don't know. Come on, this is fun.
I actually think if you die, they take you away in an ambulance anyway, right? Yeah, never mind then.
Here, put your hand on this triangle thing. It's called a planchette.
Yeah, it's not going anywhere good.
Yes, no. There's no hello.
There's usually a hello.
Now, I'll add my hand. That way we join our energies.
Yeah, and that way you'll move the planchette, but probably not. Probably a spirit will.
Now, close your eyes. Do you have them closed?
Yep.
Good. Now focus on your old babysitter's image. I found this picture of her in my father's office, Oliver says. Do you think it might help? Are you kidding? It would help a lot. Let me see.
Oh, I didn't see it in my inventory.
It's super cool, Thomas says. She really looks like a pirate. This picture will attract her spirit. Come on, put it next to the board. Let's start.
I don't know if I like this, says Oliver.
Relax. We can stop it whenever we want.
That's a mighty brave assumption, huh?
We simply say goodbye to the spirit, and she'll leave without a trace.
Yeah, you think that's the way it works, huh, Ken?
Ready?
No, yeah, I am not. Okay, we're not... I'm N? It's not really going over letters.
You're moving it, says Oliver. It's not me, it's your nanny's spirit.
I'm N-O.
I'm not.
Thomas, are you bleeding? Oliver says, Do you have a leak? Oh, it's not coming from... It's coming from the ceiling. The bathroom is right above us, says Thomas. Maybe Mom left the tap running. Of course, we have to look for it because he can't move two steps. Don't get up. I'm going to take a look. Wait here. Okay, can we look at the creepy poster? This Midnight Zombies poster is the best. Alright. So we can't look at the leak, really. We can't look at anything in this room. Thomas includes his air tank for some reason. Quick, go look in the bathroom. Maybe let me move to the side like that. I was not expecting that. Peach juice. Yeah, try drinking the peach juice. What if we go to the street instead? I hope Mrs. Jordan comes back with Tina soon. Tina's dead. Window. We have this window? No, this is the window. Our house looks beautiful from here. How about from there? Still beautiful, huh? That's the bathroom. Alright, we don't care about over there. Yeah, it's gonna be a little nasty. Oh god. Who is that? Oh my god, says Oliver. Mrs. Jordan. But how? I don't get it. If this is Mrs. Jordan, who's with Tina? Tina? Tina, are you there? That Mrs. Jordan is not the real Mrs. Jordan. Mrs. Jordan is dead. There's blood everywhere. Tina, do you hear me? I have to go to the pier, quickly. Well, we don't want to look at the body, do we? Okay. Oh. Thomas says, Oliver, what is it? I heard you screaming. It was the bathtub. Should we tell him the truth? Listen to me. I have to go find Tina. You stay here and call the police. Do what I tell you. The police? Because of an open tap? Just do it, and tell them to come fast. But, Oliver! I mean, I guess the police would still come. He's not going to have anything to say to them, though. What's the police's phone number? Oh god, 911, kid. I can't go back in and tell him. Alright, I know the other way. Alright, let's go. Oh, the roadkill is gone. No time to lose. I have to go to the pier. This clock is all wrong. Gone. Tina! Oh no, she's gone. Footprints. Two of them look normal, the rest not really. There are footprints leading to the path that borders the lake.
Has Mrs. Jordan's double taken Tina into the woods? But why? I have to go find her.
This is gonna bring her to the painting, the wraith painting thing.
What the hell?
Tina? Veronica? What is the crazy squirrel doing? Trying to eat the flashlight?
My flashlight!
Easy, easy!
If I get closer, it will bite me.
I got closer!
Yeah, I can walk right past it. Do we have anything? Build a toy truck at it? Here, have fun.
Why would it be interested in the toy truck? Or the flashlight, for that matter.
Okay.
Are those leaves, or is it snowing out?
Tina, thank goodness I found you! Are you okay? I thought I'd lost you forever.
Tina says, come with me, Oliver.
Where are you going?
Tina?
Achievement unlocked. Clicked on all crows.
Oh! Oh, what was that?
Tina, where are you?
No, wait. I didn't click the other crow. I'm not going back until I find Tina. Oh, I missed it. Missed the achievement.
Yeah, it's pretty spooky.
Oh, brother.
Veronica! Oh my god! What is happening?
Oh!
That was the Mrs. The old babysitter.
My little Oliver, it's time for bed. May I sing you a lullaby?
I don't think he wants a lullaby from you.
They're taking a picture of that old modern art.
Detective Taylor says, don't worry, we'll find them, even if we have to turn the world upside down.
I don't think you're going to be doing that.
I've never seen anything like it. Two children kidnapped, the neighbor brutally murdered in her bathtub, the babysitter missing. What the hell happened here tonight?
Agent Davis says, Detective, we found Veronica Turner, the babysitter, in the woods.
She's dead.
Also murdered?
It seems so.
Damn it.
There's something else, but you better see it with your own eyes.
I want to ask about the kids, too. Guess we'll find out. I guess we gotta walk over there. Yep. God, poor girl. Look at her wounds. It looks like a wild animal attack. A wild animal doesn't murder people in their bathtubs or kidnap children, though. Davis says, if you think that's strange, you haven't seen it all yet. Take a look at the rock. What am I supposed to see here? Agent, point the light at the painting. What the hell? Oh boy. Hello, I. Poor Oliver, poor Tina. We might never know what happened to them. But don't fret. Something tells me Detective Taylor won't rest until she finds an answer. For now, it's a secret between the two siblings and the creature of the forest. Thank you very much for enjoying this new chapter of Midnight Scenes with us. Remember to shut your windows and lock your doors tight before bed. Creatures of the night are lurking. Good night and sweet dreams. Well, thank you. Such a nice eye. Giving us all that sound advice. So I hope you enjoyed that little adventure. Actually, gonna be a two-parter, believe it or not. The other two were shorter. I enjoyed it a lot. It's a lot more light on the puzzles than the other two. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in another Let's Play. And always, seek adventure.